In how many ways can Jason, Linneo, and Kelvin arrange themselves in a straight line? So para masagot natin ang tanong na ito, kailangan natin gumawa ng illustration. So pwede na mauuna si Jason, then Linneo, then followed by Kelvin. So this is one possible arrangement. Pwede rin na si Jason, Kelvin, and Linneo yung magiging arrangement. Or we can also have Kelvin, Jason, Linneo, or Kelvin, Linneo, Jason. Pwede rin Linneo, Jason, Kelvin, and lastly, pwede rin Linneo, Kelvin, and Jason. So kung bibilangin natin, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 6 ways. So there are 6 ways for Jason, Linneo, and Kelvin to arrange themselves in a straight line. So ano ba yung gagamitin natin na concept para mas madaling masagot yung problem na ito? Good day, learners. Today we're going to talk about permutation. So what is permutation? A permutation is an arrangement of things in a definite order or the ordered arrangement of distinguishable objects without allowing repetitions among the objects. So gaya ng binigay sa situation kanina, we're going to arrange a particular set of objects or things or persons or people. So, those arrangements should be in ordered. Okay? So, kung mapapansin natin kanina, walang paulit-ulit na arrangement. So, in general, if n is a positive integer, then n factorial denoted by n factorial, so ang pagbasa nito is n factorial, okay, is the product of all integers less than or equal to n. So, ito yung gagamitin natin para ma-solve yung problem kanina. So, in symbols, yung n factorial is equal to n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 times up to 2 times 1. And, at the special case, 0 factorial is equal to 1. At para mas lalong maintindihan ang ibig sabihin ng factorial, I have here some examples. Suppose we have 7 factorial. So pag sinabi natin factorial, all we need to do is to multiply all the natural numbers less than or equal to our given n. So yung given n natin dito is si 7. So, i-multiply natin lahat ng natural numbers less than or equal to 7. So, we will have 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 and times 1. So, hanggang 1. And its product would be our answer, 5040. So, ganito lang kadali. Next, we have 5 factorial. So, since 5 factorial, therefore, yung pinakaunang natural number na imumultiply natin is 5. So, we have 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So, in decreasing order lang. Yung last na digit would be, or yung last number would be equal to 1. So, its product would be 120. Next example, we have 4 factorial times 2 factorial. So, pag dalawang factorial magkadikit, ibig sabihin nito, we're going to get the product of their factorial. So, sa 4 factorial, we can write that one as 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. At yung 2 factorial naman, we can write that one as 2 times 1. Finally, multiplying them, the answer would be equal to 48. We also have 8 factorial divided by 6 factorial. So, this would be division. So sa numerator, we have 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 divided by 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So pwede natin silang i-multiply or kukunin natin yung product sa numerator at kukunin din natin yung product sa denominator. Or it could also, or we can also cancel kung ano man yung mga common factors nila. So we can cancel 1 and 2. Pwede natin cancel si 2. We can also cancel 3, 4, and 5, and also 6. So pag sinabi natin cancel, ibig sabihin nito, they are all equal to 1. So yung matitira na lang natin would be 8 times 7. So 8 times 7 is equal to 56. Therefore, the final answer is equal to 56. Now, going back sa first problem natin, in how many ways can Jason, Nino, and Kelvin arrange themselves in a straight line? So, yung pinakaunang concept under permutation is that we can use n factorial to solve this kind of problem. So, instead of illustrating, pwede nating directly ma-solve na yung problem. So, we have n taken n. So, yung pagbase nito is n taken n. So, n taken n is equal to n factorial. P stands for permutation. Okay? So, yung number or yung value ng n natin would be equal to 3 because we have 3 persons that we need to arrange or they need to arrange themselves in a straight line. So, 3 taken 3 is equal to 3 factorial. As we all know, yung ibig sabihin ng 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1. Multiplying them, our answer would be 6 ways. So, using n factorial, mas madali nating malalaman or i-arrange yung different things or objects na ibibigay sa problem. Let's have another example. In how many ways can Mrs. Elsa arrange 8 planted plants in a row? So same pa rin yung formula na gagamitin natin, n factorial pa rin. So we have 8 taken 8. So kung mapapansin natin, equal lang yung n natin dito. Ibig sabihin, we're going to consider all the objects na given. So, lahat ng 8 planted plants ay i-arrange natin at the same time. So, we have 8 factorial. 8 factorial means 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Multiplying them, we have 40,320 ways. And this would be our final answer. Next example, we have, in how many ways can 6 people arrange themselves in a row for picture taking? So, same pa rin yung formula na gagamitin natin. Yung value ng n natin dito is 6. 6 factorial is 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And our final answer is 720 ways. How about this problem? 8 runners join a race. In how many possible ways can they be arranged as first, second, and third placers? So this is still under permutation. Pero kung papansinin natin, out of 8 players or 8 runners, we are going to arrange only 3 people at the same time. So we have 1, or the first, the second, and the third placers. So this would be from 8 people, we're going to arrange 3 at a time. And we call this one as the permutation of n objects taken r at a time. And its formula is given as n taken r is equal to n factorial all over n minus r factorial, where n is greater than or equal to r. So, halos same lang siya ng concept kanina, but this time, we're going to make use of r. So, let's solve the given problem. So, sa problem natin, yung value ng n is 8. So, yung n is yung total number or of objects or persons na binabanggit sa problem. And yung r naman natin is 3. So, bakit 3? So, we're going to take 3 persons at a time. Kasi nga, we're going to arrange them as first, second, and third placers. So, we are going to use the formula n taken r is equal to n factorial all over the quantity of n minus r factorial. Then, isa-substitute lang natin yung given n at r natin. So, sa denominator, we have 8 minus 3. Isi-simplify muna natin ito. So, we will have 8 factorial over 5 factorial. Then, pwede tayong gumamit ng calculator or pag wala tayong calculator, then we need to solve them manually. So, sa numerator, we have 8 times 7 times 6 times 4. 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Again, we can cancel the common factors. We have 5, 4, so, magiging gawa na lang itong mga factors na na-cancel natin. 2 and 1. So, yung matitira na lang would be 8, 7, and 6. And we are going to multiply them. The answer is 336 ways. Next example. In how many ways can 7 books be arranged in a shelf if there is space enough for only 4 books? So, we're going to arrange 4 books at a time. Okay? So, out of 7 books, 4 books yung i-arrange natin at a time. So, isusulat muna natin yung given. We have n is equal to 7. Ito yung total number of books. And we're going to arrange 4 books at a time. Therefore, 4 is our r. Then, we're going to use the formula. Substitute natin yung mga given. Simplify muna natin yung sa denominator na 7 minus 4. So, magiging 7 factorial over 3 factorial. Then, expand lang natin yung factorial natin. We have 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And sa denominator naman, we have 3 times 2 times 1. Cancel natin yung mga common factors. So, ika-cancel natin si 3, 2, and 1. Magiging 1 sila. Then, ang matitira na lang, we have 7 times 6 times 5. And their product would be 840 ways. So, our final answer is 840. And for our last example, how many 3-digit numbers can be formed using the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 without repetition. So, kung bibilangin natin, we have 9 digits. And we're going to arrange 3 digits at a time. So, yung given natin, we have 9, or n is equal to 9. At yung r naman natin is equal to 3. Using the formula, this is the permutation of n objects taken r at a time. We're going to substitute now the given. Simplify lang natin yung nasa denominator. So, we will have 9 factorial over 6 factorial. Then, cancel out natin yung mga common factors. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So, magiging equal to 1 sila lahat. So, yung i-multiply na lang natin would be 9, 8, and 7. 9 times 8 times 7 is equal to 504. Therefore, we have 504 3-digit numbers that we can form out of the given 9 digits. Now it's your turn. Try to answer the following questions. We'll be right back.
And that's a wrap. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel, Sir Nino. And you can also post your math problems in the comment section. And we will do our very best to provide solution to your questions. Because remember, every problem has a solution. At kung math ang problema ninyo, ako ang kagapay ninyo, ako ang Sir Nino.